Hello, I'm PJ Detroya from ADI Internal Analytics Team. And in today's video, we'll explore how Celonis process mining tool could actually support us at Nestlé to optimize our ITSM processes. What I'll demo today is the outcome of a proof of concept that we have built on the past 4 months in collaboration with Osvaldo from Workforce 360, TJ from ADI ASL team, Colin, our ServiceNow architect, and Vlad, our Celonis expert. So first of all, let me express my thanks to you all for your highly valuable collaboration on this project so far. So in this video, we'll do a walkthrough to all the pages we developed upon ServiceNow incident data. I'll also share some tips and some basics of Celonis, so that hopefully this demo can also be used as a hands-on tutorial on this famous process mining tool. So the target audience are first the participants to the next steps of the POC, but more generally, anyone interested in either ITSM process optimization or anyone curious to watch a practical case of data mining at Nestlé and hopefully start to feel the benefits and savings that such advanced analytics might bring to the company. In our example with incidents management, how this might help us to speed up the time to resolution and uncover our process weaknesses or bottlenecks. Just a few words on the backend and the scope of what you'll see in the tool in a minute. So this is actual data from our Nestlé ServiceNow instance. More precisely, all the incidents created since the beginning of this year, 2020, till end of August. So already 8 full months history, which represents more or less 2 million of tickets. The incidents in Celonis terms will be represented as cases. And as you know, each of these incidents during its lifetime leaves interesting footprints in our system. For example, when an agent changes its state from new to work in progress, then when it is marked as resolved, etc. So all these changes on the state have been injected in Celonis and will be considered as an activity in Celonis terms. And last but not least, we also capture all the different assignments of each incident, when it was reallocated from an AG to another AG, etc. These changes are also considered as activities, and AGs are what we will sometimes name actors in Celonis. In addition to these activities and actors, we also enrich the model with some of the most common dimensions we typically use in the ServiceNow ITSM Power BI dashboard, so the incidents priorities, the categories, subcategories, etc. Their location, so the zone, the region, the market, and also the product taxonomy, including the product streams, product groups, and applications. So this is, in a nutshell, the data model that we've implemented and on which all the analyses you'll see are built on. Finally, note that we have 3 main roles in Celonis. So first, the data engineers who are responsible to build, load, and maintain the data model in the tool. Then the analysts who are able to create and edit analyses. And finally, viewers who can, as you guessed, only view or use the analyses that have been shared with them. And all this demo will be done using this last simple viewer role, and you'll see it can already bring you very valuable insights on our incidents workflow. So without further ado, let's jump into the tool. So here is the welcome page of Celonis, and let's find our ServiceNow ITSM Process Manager analysis, which is located under Projects, Innovation, Innovation ASL, IT Service Management, and here it is. One first tip is to add it to your favorites by selecting it, then hit the star icon on the right, so that next time you'll easily access it from your start folder. Let's now open the analysis by double-clicking it. So here is the first page named Case Distribution, and prior to deep dive what this page offers, let me explain some generalities on Celonis first. On the header, you'll always find the number of cases currently filtered versus total. As a reminder, cases in our data model represent incidents. On this left pane, we propose you some standard filters such as the period of analysis or the incidence categories. And from here, you can either select or filter out some values. Let's, for example, remove from our entire analysis the monitoring alerts. You see now on the header, there are about 476K incidents, which refers to 25% of total cases. Next to this, you'll see the current filter blocks that will be appended. We'll come back to this later. Other filters proposed on our left pane are the AG dimensions, so the usual AG parent stream, etc., as well as the incidence product dimensions from product stream till the application, and finally the incidence location hierarchy. And you can also use simply any chart to set some filters. Example here on this horizontal bar chart, which distributes the number of incidents per zone. Let's focus on M&A by clicking the corresponding bar, then hit this keep selection green tick. Here we are. Then on most of our charts, we propose you drill down capabilities. On that one, as you see, you can drill down to regions, then to markets, where for example, we can select Switzerland. As you can see here, every filter are appended to the header. And you can also from there affine your selection. For example, selecting France and Germany in addition to Switzerland. And we could also have inverted the filter to filter out some markets. Let's keep these three ones for now. On the top right chart, we combine several incident level dimensions, such as the category, the subcategory, the contact type, etc. Let's for example select the priority, and from this chart we can decide to concentrate on P1 to P3 incidents only. So this is how you can start to build your filters to narrow the scope of your analysis. And when you're happy with your selection, you can save it as a bookmark thanks to these drop-down options, and even share this to a colleague from this share button on top right. This link will automatically open this page with all the filters you've set so far. Let's for now filter out only the monitoring alerts, and we now depict more precisely what this first page offers you. So in addition to the two charts we've already seen, you have on the bottom left a standard trend of the number of incidents by month that you can drill down to weeks. This chart shows you at the same time the amount of incidents and their average throughput. That is basically the overall duration from start to end of the incident. We'll come back to the throughput in a second with the top left chart. The two last bar charts are also very standard ones, similar to what you have on the ITSM incident Power BI dashboard, and are showing the distribution of incidents by the AG hierarchy, so from AG parent stream to the AG stream and finally the AGs themselves. Then the distribution of incidents by their product hierarchy, also here with the possibility to drill down from the product stream till the application. Till now, one might argue that this is not bringing much value to our existing Power BI dashboards. You're right, and thanks for your patience so far. And we'll now discover some pure Celonis widgets. So for example, this top left chart that is categorizing the incidents by their average throughput time. You can from here decide to change the computation to median or trim mean, which is calculated by cutting off the top 5% and the bottom 5% of values. You can also display the results in hours instead of days, and you can decide to narrow your analysis between two states. For example, looking only at the time spent between new till in progress states, and analyze deeply this time to assign KPI. Let's come back to the default view, that is to look the average duration in days between the first occurrence of state in progress till the last resolved state, so that we avoid counting here the standard 7 days from an incident to move automatically from resolve to close state. And let's focus on the long runner's ticket. For example, by selecting only tickets where this time to resolve took more than 2 weeks. So as you could see, this first page case distribution offers many possibilities to narrow your analysis by putting in place some filters. Let's move on the second page named throughput distribution, which is very similar to the first one, but where the four distribution charts on the right are now showing the average throughput in days instead of the count of cases. And from this chart, for example, you can easily spot the ages involved on incidents where the average durations are the longest. So let's select security and compliance parent stream, then drill down to the next level so that we compare the security and compliance stream's average throughput. Remember, we are still looking only at the incidents where the route from in progress to resolved took more than 2 weeks. So this is normal. We see here only long durations. I don't want to finger point any team in this demo. And this is also why I applied these filters that you can challenge. Potentially, these teams are mostly involved on incidents which took only 3 days to resolve, or their involvement on these incidents is in fact very minor, so are not the cause of these long durations. And you'll see later, for example, how to get more precisely the ownership percentage per AG. But for the sake of the demo, let's continue and select only these top three streams. So if necessary, you could continue to drill down and compare the throughputs at the AG level. And note that we can, of course, combine the filters, for example, looking at the incidents where these security AGs were involved, but where the impacted product was not a security and compliance product by hitting this invert selection option. So here we can see we reduced the scope of our analysis to only 92 incidents. Let's remove this last filter we set on product stream, and we are now back to 2000 cases. We'll continue with these filters for now. And let's move on to the next tab, the rework analysis. This page will offer you different charts related to reassignments or multi-ops. So for example, this rework ratio, which is calculating the percentage of incidents that came more than once to the same AG. The next chart, number of incidents by collaboration, is distributing the tickets by the number of AGs who were involved in the lifetime of the ticket. So for example, you might wonder what are these incidents where more than 10 different AGs were involved. Select them and hit keep the selection green tick to add this to your filters. And let's take the opportunity to present you the two last tabs, because this is where you will be able at any moment to drill down to the tickets themselves. On the Case Explorer, you can select any incident and browse on the Case Details pane on the right all the different activities this incident went through. And by developing these activities, see the actor, so the AG in our data model, who was handling the incident at this moment. And the next page, Case Details List, is also listing the tickets with some of their key dimensions, with here the possibility to directly access the incident in ServiceNow. If you need to go at the lowest level and read the full history of notes of this ticket. Remember, you can in ServiceNow filter the type of notes you'd like to see. For example, if we focus on the AG changes and states changes, you'll recognize here the sequence of activities that we were seeing in Celonis. So to summarize, sometimes no need to open ServiceNow. Already a lot of info is available at your fingertips in the Case Explorer page. But if needed, you have this direct link to ServiceNow also available for you in the Case Details list. Back to the rework analysis, and let me remove some filters and come back only on the long runners for security AGs. On this top right chart, you can see the percentage of tickets where a security AG was actually the last AG in the incident's journey. And I'll show you in the next tab how you can select and concentrate on these incidents where a selected AG is the last actor. We also have this horizontal bar chart, number of activities by AG, currently at the stream level. So remember that a perfect path for an incident is to have only 4 activities, new, in progress, resolved, and closed. Thus, ideal journey should be in average 4 activities per incident. As we can see, role service teams are involved on tickets that have in average 13 activities. To illustrate what this means actually, let's focus on this stream and pick up in the Case Explorer one ticket, let's say this one, which indeed went through 25 activities in total. So as you can see, even during its new phase, it was reassigned to several AGs before finally moving to the in-progress state, where by the way, he also ping-ponged between numerous AGs. You can easily spot on the right the relative age of each activity versus your latest selected activity. Once again, let's remove this last filter and we'll now move on one of the key pages of the analysis, the Process and Social Explorer. We have here two visualizations. First, on the left, the Process Explorer is showing you the most common states and routes the incident reached. So new, in progress, resolved, closed. You can see that this journey is covering almost 81% of the cases. And if we add here the next most common activity used, we'll be adding the on-all state. And since we now have all possible states, we're obviously covering 100% of our cases. Then we can also increase to the next most common connections by hitting this plus button. You see we are showing now more and more routes covering now 85% of the paths that our tickets followed. You can select any link and see at a glance the proportion of tickets who followed this connection during their lifetime. From here, you can decide to focus or filter out the incidents who followed at least once this route. And by clicking on a node, so a ticket state in this process flow, you can, for example, filter only the tickets who passed through this state at least once, or on the opposite, all the incidents who never went to on hold during their whole lifetime. Remember, we are still only looking at long runners. So indeed, might be interesting to see what caused these tickets to last more than 2 weeks whilst they were never put on hold, meaning they were most probably stuck or ping-ponging during their in-progress phase. Well, this is just a proposal of analysis. You can imagine and try by yourself many very different process mining techniques that this tool and especially this page, by combining these two visualizations, are enabling. But let's continue with some tips. On the top left chart, you have the possibility to show the durations in days, hours, or even minutes. And from here, you can switch the metric to, for example, case frequency, so that on the connections, you now see the number of incidents who took this path instead of the average duration of this path. So that was the Process Explorer, where each node represents a state of the ticket. And let's move on the right visualization, where the nodes are now the different ages that the incidents were assigned to. And the paths are now the reallocations from one AG to another. Again, you can increase the number of nodes, so here, go to the next AG, the most commonly used, and you can also increase the number of visible connections between all these actors. As previously, you can also change the metric and display the average throughput in time of each relation and start to identify where the tickets are taking time to progress, where are the bottlenecks, and assess the efficiency of the collaborations between the different AGs. And if you spot a relationship that might require a deeper analysis, you can focus on it. Or by selecting a node, so for us a specific AG, and select among these different options, you can decide to concentrate on the incidents where this AG was the last actor, so the closure AG. Remember to keep an eye on the header to understand all the different filters that are currently applied, and clear them if necessary. Last but not least, this play button might give you an interesting dynamic animation of all the different routes of your incidents. This can help you to visually detect where the tickets are losing time. And the trend preview on the bottom can also give you at a glance an idea of the volume evolution amongst the weeks, if there were some peaks at certain periods, etc. So this is not just a shiny feature. I do believe it can actually bring you some insight. And this was just a very short introduction to the Process and Social Explorers page, which is, as I said, one key enabler of our POC. I strongly invite you to play a lot with this page, using the filters on either the connections or the nodes, because this is actually where you start to data mine your incident process. And hopefully, will allow you to identify the bottlenecks, potentially some irregular routes, etc. I'll now quickly introduce you more to out-of-the-box analyses that are proposed by Celonis, and that we also included in our POC. And so, let's first open the conformance analysis. And let me just remove most of our filters and come back to our initial scope of all incidents but monitoring alerts. So this page will show you the tickets that are not following the standard process and what are the kind of violations to the process we currently have. By clicking here on the left menu, the View Process Model, you'll access the model we defined as normal. So these are all the states and routes that an incident can take and still be considered as confirmed. Let's go back to the overview. After the trending of conformance history, you have the different deviations to the process that the system identified. As we can see, proportionally, we don't have that much, but still, some interesting cases might be investigated deeper. For example, these incidents that started directly with a closed state, or these ones which came back to new whilst they were already in progress. Let's investigate further this violation. You'll see here a trend and the overall number of these violation cases. And the system can perform for you a root cause analysis, which consists in finding similarities on all these cases and propose you this as explanation. From here, you can also decide to go even further and see these cases in another page, for example, by listing these incidents in our case explorer view. We can pick one randomly and indeed observe that it ping-ponged back to in new whilst it was already in the in-progress state, which is not a standard journey. Back to previous page, if you consider this is not a big issue and you want to focus on other process violations, you can add this one to the whitelist so that it won't appear anymore and these cases won't be considered as an issue. Reselect this violation by browsing this whitelist link to remove it from the whitelist. We also prepared a conformance page dedicated to monitoring alerts with a different default process model, but for the sake of time, I won't present it now. Feel free to discover it by yourself. And let's move to the next page, the PI social. So this page is more focusing on the actors, so the ages in our data model, giving you on the top some general statistics such as the number of active ages per day, the average daily number of events per AG, and the trend of number of incidents per AG. This bubble cloud can give you at a glance some interesting insights. By default, the color and the size of the bubbles both represent the number of events that the AGs handled. So with no surprise, we find here the service desk AGs with the biggest bubbles. But by hitting the throughput time button here, you'll keep the same size of the bubbles, but the color now represents the average throughput time from fast in yellow to slow in red. So for example, this AG handles quite a substantial number of incidents whilst having an average throughput time of 39 days. Let's select it. Here below, you now find some statistics specifically for this selected AG, including the events and activities per day, and also the top three AGs that are sending incidents to this AG. But we'll see in another page how to get even more details on these originating AGs. You can go further on this AG by hitting this Go to Profile button, and you'll reach this detailed page showing once again some stats and a trend of activities performed by this team, categorized by the different incident states that this AG was contributing to. Here, for example, we can easily spot a peak in June, where this group was handling numerous incidents that were in on-hold status. Finally, a daily profile to show at what hours of the day this AG is mostly working. I'll quickly present the next page named Process Overview, which is another out-of-the-box analysis proposed by Celonis. We have here an overview of the measures of our model, the cases per day, the events per day, and the throughput time, which in this case is the trimmed mean duration, as a reminder, calculated by removing the top 5% and the bottom 5% of values. Then a standard trend of the throughput time that we already proposed in the two first tabs. And this section, Happy Path, is considering that the optimal path is to go only once through these four states. This is of course stricter than the process model we define in the conformance analysis, but might give you a flavor of what the system interprets as the normal path for your selection. It also proposes you some other activities, for example the on-hold state that has also been observed but is not part of the optimal process because increasing the throughput time. There are possibilities to deep dive into this on-hold activity and the system shows you other stats and measures. I will let you play and discover this by yourself. This is quite self-explanatory. On this page, you can also focus on the throughput times figures, but again here, no need to spend too much time. This is something that is somehow already available in our other pages, especially this possibility to change the calculation logic from average to median or trimmed mean, etc. To conclude on this process overview page, this last section is listing you the bottlenecks that have been automatically identified by the system as causes of increasing time to resolution. You can see at a glance the number of incidents affected and the impact on the throughput time. And if necessary, select from here the cases that are falling into this bottleneck and continue your investigations in another page. Last but not least, this AEG analysis is a custom development that we proposed, where you'll have to use the filters that are embedded in the page, so not the standard ones. Let's select, for example, as target AEG this subbasis bobi_dxc. So this first chart will sort you the AEGs that are sending the most of activities to your AEG, which, if you remember, was partially visible in the PI social page, but only for the top three AEGs and without any precise figures. And this second chart shows you, month by month, the number of incidents and activities handled by your selected AEG. For example, here, we can identify a peak in June and July, where this AEG contributed to 41 cases, performing in average 2 actions by incident. Finally, let's remove the target AEG filter, and we'll move on the right part of the page. Select here one or several source AEGs, and by the way, let me take the opportunity for a last tip. You can combine some filters even by starting from the same chart. Example, you first select the AEG names which contain DXC, then click again on the chart and filter AEG names which contain workflow. As you can see on the header, both filters are applied, meaning we have here the three AEGs that contains both DXC and workflow. And so, what do we see on this right chart? For each AEG, you'll have the total number of cases where this AEG was involved, the sum of throughputs of this incident, considering all AEGs who handled this incident, and the time spent by this AEG only, from which we can then derive the ownership percentage. So for example, this first AEG RPA admin was involved on more incidents than the two others, but was in average consuming 24% of the overall incidence duration. Whilst this AEG, involved in 231 incidents, spent in total 3,719 days, and this represents in average an ownership of 38% of the incidents. Hopefully these additional measures might be useful for some of you. And we already saw several times the detailed list, but just to remind you, the Case Explorer, where you can easily check all the activities and actors this incident went through, and the case details list, where you'll find the direct link to ServiceNow. And that's it for this first demo of Celonis using our ServiceNow incidents data. As a reminder, this is just a POC, still in progress. The next steps will be to assess if this tool is worth further investment or not, or if we should wait for ServiceNow to offer in-tool process mining, which might come in a couple of versions. If you're interested in getting access to the tool and participate to the proof of value, please simply fill out this form, Participation to POC ServiceNow Incident Management Mining with Celonis. You'll find the link in the description of this post. We'll be more than happy to receive your submission and hopefully welcome you on board. To conclude, remember, all this was only incidents data. We might imagine to also use Celonis upon other objects we have in our ServiceNow instance, requests, HR cases, enhancements, projects, etc. Or even data outside ServiceNow. As long as we have some structured data with activities and timestamp, most probably we can configure Celonis to use it. I'm personally very impressed and convinced by the tool and more generally by data mining opportunities. I really believe that even this simple POC can actually help us to optimize our processes and save us cost. And please trust me, I'm not sponsored in any way by Celonis for saying this. That's just my very personal, genuine and honest opinion. Okay, I stop here. Thank you so much for watching. I do hope you enjoyed this video and I'll see you next time. Bye bye.